Welcome, geniuses. I'm Gene, your best buddy for A-levels. In this channel, we'll bring you to explore the secret formula behind success.
This is the requested video, and the questions of May, June 2016, variant 7-2, question 1. Okay, the length of time in minutes taken by people to complete a task has mean 53.0 and standard deviations 6.2. Find the probability that the mean time taken to complete the task by a random sample of 50 people is more than 51 minutes. All right, so let's see the keyword. In these questions, we are going to find probability of the mean time. So this is the keyword. All right, so the mean time. So that means we are looking at the X bar distributions, and X bar distribution follows normal distribution, where the mean is given by mu and the variance is given by sigma square, but don't forget, divided by the random sample size. All right. Hence, for this particular question, the mean, the x bar, the mean time is following normal distributions with the mean given 53.0. And since the standard deviation is given, so I will write down like this, 6.2 need to be square and divided by the sample size of 50 people. All right, so to find the probability of the mean time more than 51. So first step, we have to carry out standardizations. So it becomes Z, and the working is like this. 51 minus the mean divided by the standard deviations. All right, the standard deviation should be written by 6.2 divided by square root 50, because we need to square root the variance to get the standard deviations. All right, so by using calculator, find out the value of this, and it's going to be negative 2.281. So always find out the z-score value up to 3 decimal places, because when we refer to the table, we can read up to 3 decimal places to get the probability. All right, so now I sketch the bell-shaped curve the standardized bell-shaped curve, where 0 is in the middle and negative 2.281 should be on the left hand side here, negative 2.281. so since the question is looking for the z-score greater than, that means I'm going to find out the area towards the right. And what must we know? The area under the bell-shaped curve gives you the probability. Okay, but the thing is, when you refer to the table, you are not able to read the negative z-score value. So for that, we are trying to rearrange it like this. So instead of referring to negative 2.281, we refer to the positive 2.281. And the area that we want is from positive 2.281 towards the left, like this. And the reasons we can do this is because bell-shaped curve is symmetrical. All right, so I will write down like this. 2.281. Okay, so now we need to refer to the normal distribution table to get the probability. So let's have a look at the normal distribution table down here. Okay, so we have the z-score value 2.281. All right, so some might write it down as this, 2.281. So the z-score is reading from this first column here up to the first decimal place, 2.2. Okay, so we have 2.2 here. And then the second decimal place, we read from this row. So we are having the 8 over here. So from 2.2 and the 8, the intersections will be 0.9887. All right, so that is the probability that we want. And the last decimal place is 1. You have to read from the smaller column here. So 1. And the value we have is 0. So in order to get the probability, should be 0.9887 plus with 0.00000, and which is just 0.9887. All right. Hence, we found the answer for these questions. The probability is 0.9887. And we keep the answer to 3 significant figures. So it gives us 0.989. Okay, 3 significant figures. Hence, this is the answer for this particular question. That's all for this video. Bye-bye.
That's all for today's video.
If you are interested in more genuine sharing by other geniuses, please subscribe to our channel and don't forget to turn on the notification bell. Ding dong.
Also, if you're struggling with one or two past year questions and the mark scheme just doesn't seem to help, Genie has got you covered. Feel free to let us know what question it is by filling in the Google form linked in the description below.
GenieUs Hub will get genius teachers to fulfill your request for the solution.
Genie,
we'll see you next time.
Bye-bye.